There's so many little beeps and blings. Design thinking is really actually not as much about thinking as it is about making and observing what happens when you make something and put it in people's hands. The reason I think games are so interesting to make and to study is because games are actually little miniature systems, and the biggest problems in the world are systemic. So if we can make a system out of it and we can play with that system, then we can begin to understand how it works. And even better, if we can try to design a system, if we can make a game about something, we're really getting under the hood and we're really learning about that thing at a deeper level. The work that I do is all about making opportunities to play with things in the real world. So that could be anything from a game about the Electoral College, to the federal deficit, to what to do in the case of a flood. One of the really interesting things that a game designer does is they make failure feel good. So game designers are, I would say, failure experts. We're really trying to craft those moments of failure in a game to provide a learning opportunity for players to be able to say, well, it didn't work that way. How can I try a different approach or a new strategy? Failure in games teaches us how to think about failure in real life as an opportunity for creativity, learning something by reckoning with our failure, actually paying attention to it. Failure is like a flashlight that can show the path to new directions or new possibilities that we wouldn't have seen without failing. I think games, even though we think of them as a pastime, as leisure, I think, interestingly enough, they can hold the key to helping us understand how the world works.